Have you ever wanted to walk on magma? You actually can. Magma, when it crystallizes, actually becomes granite. Hey guys, Nikhil from Home Banao. In this video, we'll talk about granite flooring. Let's get into the video. So granite flooring is one of the most common options when you're looking at options for different flooring in your home or office or any other space. I wanted to talk about advantages, disadvantages, and recommend where you should use granite flooring. So let's get into the advantages first. Compared to any flooring option, granite is the most durable flooring options in the marketplace. It can last you 3-4 generations together. There are certain monuments which have been built in granite which have absolutely not faded for years and years and years. Unlike a lot of other floorings like vitrified tiles, ceramic tiles, or even marble, granite does not fade easily. It takes decades and decades together to fade even a little bit. Now, when you buy a piece of granite, you know that you're getting a unique piece. No two pieces of granite will be completely similar. That's because it is cut straight from a natural piece of rock. And it's almost impossible to get two completely similar granite pieces. When you come to installation, installing granite is comparatively easy when you compare with wooden or even marble flooring because it doesn't require additional polishing, buffing or things like that. When you buy granite, it comes pre-polished from the factory. The reason is polishing granite requires an industrial setup. So they pre-polish it and they sell it to you ready to install and it can be installed fairly easily. So granite, compared to a lot of other flooring options, in a more scratch scale, are the highest. They don't scratch, they don't stain, they are very durable, and the best part is they are even fire resistant. So it is a very good option if maintenance is a concern in your project. And compared to marble, they are even more cooler throughout the year in summer or winter. And this is a great add-on when you are talking about areas where the temperature gets quite high. Granite can keep the home cool. So these are some of the advantages. Let's get into the disadvantages. Because you're buying something which is naturally occurring, the pricing fluctuates like crazy. It just depends on the customer and the seller. I mean, he can sell it to you at a very high price, he can even sell it to you at a low price, and the difference between a high price and low price granite will be very minimal. Unlike an artificial flooring like vitrified tiles or wooden, where you know what two different pieces of flooring costs and why. Wherein marble, you can make it look as though the whole flooring is seamless. Granite, it's very, very challenging to make it appear as seamless. The reason is it's a very coarse grain. So the grains don't match very easily when you're laying the flooring. Granite is a very dense material. This makes it extremely heavy, and logistics cost and carrying it to places and getting it installed, you'll have to be very careful because one slab of granite is extremely heavy. It's probably the heaviest flooring option in the market. And finally, if you want to buy a very exotic granite, you'll actually need to have a lot of experience looking at different types of granites and having an understanding of where it's come from and how it's actually manufactured, because it's very easy to give misinformation with granite, as there's very little knowledge available as such because most of it is developed through experience. So where would I recommend granite? Compared to every single flooring option, granite is recommended where you require very low maintenance and where there's very high traffic. So I would say using it in government offices, using it in kitchen countertops, using it in your kitchen, using it in different bathrooms where there's a lot of traffic and you don't want to worry too much about maintenance, I would suggest granite because trust me, compared to any other flooring, this is the best option for that particular use case. So hope you liked this video and got to learn something about granite flooring. Typically, granite flooring can start about 300 rupees per square feet and go all the way up to 3,000-3,500 per square feet. So just keep that in mind and keep these points in mind before making the decision. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with someone who's building a new project. Trust me, it'll help them out a lot and give them more clarity about granite. Thanks for watching. See you guys in the next video.